A visibly emotional Duchess of Sussex appeared to fight back tears as she watched a rousing musical performance from Alfie Bowe. Meghan, 37, looked tearful as she listened to the English tenor's a cappella rendition of Snow Patrol's Run during Monday's Commonwealth service at Westminster Abbey. As fellow audience members, including the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge and Prince Andrew, looked on impassively, Meghan looked visibly moved as she blinked and sniffed her way through the musical performance and footage captured by the BBC. Meghan, who is 8 months pregnant, also watched performances from Clean Bandit and the Be Positive Choir during yesterday's Commonwealth Day service of celebration. Joining senior royals including the Queen and Prince Charles at yesterday's service, Meghan wore top-to-toe Victoria Beckham, teaming a printed midi dress with a white coat and matching hat. Her sister-in-law Kate Plumpt for an old Catherine Walker ensemble consisting of a Pilar Box red coat dress, hat and nude heels. The Duchess of Sussex attended her second Commonwealth Day service, her first as a member of the royal family. And during the ceremony at Westminster Abbey, Meghan was overcome with emotion during one poignant moment. Singer Alfie Bowe performed a beautiful a cappella version of Snow Patrol's Run, and Meghan was seen tearing up as she listened to the music. The Duchess sat next to Prince Harry and the Duke of York, and looked radiant dressed in white coat, which was teamed with a black and white dress by Victoria Beckham, and pillar box hat. The royal family steps out every year to attend the service, but 2019 is particularly significant as it marks the 70th anniversary of the modern Commonwealth. The Prince of Wales and Duchess of Cornwall, along with the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, were also in attendance. Highlights of the service included musical performances by Clean Bandit and tenor Alfie Bowe. The Commonwealth plays an important part in the public life of the Queen, who famously dedicated herself to the Empire on her 21st birthday in 1947. This special occasion marks the second time that the royal family have all gone out together this month. Last Tuesday, they celebrated the 50th anniversary of the investiture of the Prince of Wales. A self-confessed music lover, Meghan picked the Kingdom Choir to perform at her May 2018 wedding to Prince Harry at Windsor Castle and has previously spoken about her feel-good tunes of choice. Writing on her now-defunct website, The Tig, in 2017 she shared a list of indie tracks which she called Songs for Positive Vibes to help her readers beat the daily rigmarole of winter blues, including artists such as Crystal Fighters and Maggie Rogers. In her list of recommendations, Meghan describes the songs are the perfect pick-me-ups winter mornings and recommends playing them before leaving the house. She wrote, "Turn these tracks on as you're getting ready in the morning, when you need a mid-afternoon pick-me-up, or during your next evening celebration. Because when the air is filled with positive vibes, there's no winter cold that can block out the warmth of happy hearts." Other guests among the 2,000-strong congregation included the Commonwealth Secretary-General Baroness Scotland, alongside High Commissioners, ambassadors, faith leaders and more than 800 schoolchildren and young people, and Theresa May. The Commonwealth represents 53 countries and almost 2.4 billion people, and 2019 marks its 70th anniversary. During a royal visit to Canada House in London, Meghan Markle and Prince Harry honored the beautiful history of the Great White North. To honor of the Duke and Duchess of Sussex's visit, Jenna Charette, the Canadian High Commissioner to the United Kingdom, surprised the royal couple with charming presents for their baby, who's reportedly due in late April. The adorable care package included clothing and accessories, all appropriately from Canadian brands. There was a white Onesie with a red maple leaf from Hop and Moo, a hat and mittens from the Hudson's Bay, and leather moccasins from Manitoba Mucklucks, an Indigenous-owned Canadian brand, according to a tweet from royal correspondent Rebecca English of Daily Mail. According to People in the Telegraph, Prince Harry even smelled the shoes to inspect whether they were made of real leather. "I'm sniffing the insides to check if they are leather or not because they are smelly," he joked to the crowd. For the event, Duchess Meghan, who is always impeccably dressed, sported a jewel-tone green Erdem coat, a fitting choice, considering the brand's designer, Erdem Mereglu, was born in Canada. Meghan also has strong ties to the North American country. She used to live in Toronto while she filmed her popular television series Suits, and also met her best friend and confidant Jessica Maroney in the city. Later this afternoon, Meghan switched from her green coat into a white ensemble complete with a pillbox hat, a fashion staple that gained favor with Jackie Onassis Kennedy and Princess Diana. Please like, comment, and subscribe to channel. Thank you for watching my video.